European and world biodiversity, healthy environments and food security depend on animal pollination. Preserving pollinating insects has become central in social, environmental and political discourse. Bees and other pollinators face ever-increasing challenges that threaten their survival and, consequently, our own. Once upon a time, pollinators moved freely in our environment, searching for sustenance and places to live and nest to harbour their offspring. Now the lack of these things due to rising temperatures, habitat loss through urbanisation, intensive farming and pollution, to name but a few, are severely affecting their survival. Many of us contribute to the quantity or quality of these resources. Environmental, agricultural, and food safety authorities, farmers, beekeepers, researchers, and citizens. We all require information to perform our activities better and to be able to support them. But we also create information for our own purposes, which, if shared, can help others in their activities. These efforts, conducted by authorities, academia, and citizens, continuously provide data on relevant parameters, such as bee mortality, intoxication, pests, land use, and others. However, all this data loses its full potential through a lack of integration. This pollinator crisis demands a more collaborative and integrated approach and sustainable solutions. As with a successful and healthy bee colony, we must come together and share observations and processes in a visual and collective manner, so that we may understand the problem and implement solutions. The EU Pollinator Hub, a new integrative platform, is trying to respond to this need. A visual, integrated pollinator data collector from all sources. It applies a collaborative, open-sourced approach to establish new data partnerships for the well-being of pollinators and their pivotal role in our environment. This integrative platform is free to use, trustworthy, and directed to support the efforts to improve environmental conditions for both managed and wild pollinators. The Internet of Bees project allowed us to create a proof of concept in 2020, which was later developed into a prototype version thanks to the European Food Safety Authority, EFSA, the agency in charge of assessing the risk of regulated pesticides and contaminants. EFSA continues supporting the EU Pollinator Hub development and BeeLife coordinates it. BeeLife is an NGO working on the protection of pollinators and chairing the EU Bee Partnership, a stakeholder group with interests in data sharing on pollinator health in the EU. The platform will be fully operational by 2024. The EU Pollinator Hub is also collaborating with the Apimondia BXML group to advance on practical data standardisation by establishing a compatible, shareable and accessible environment. The platform works on three levels of development: data acquisition, data integration and data visualisation. The first step is data acquisition, when new data providers decide to share their data with the platform, an agreement is made with respect to the needs of the new data provider. Data providers might be authorities, national or European projects, producers of beehive or pollinator monitoring systems, farming or beekeeping associations, among others. An agreement is reached in which the EU Pollinator Hub will only process and visualize the data provided. The original owner retains the data ownership, and providers can freely withdraw their consent for sharing or visualizing the data on the platform. In data integration, the new data is introduced into the larger database of the platform. This includes both static and dynamic datasets. Static datasets are the ones which will not include new data in the future. In this case, it is a one-time input. On the other hand, dynamic datasets have a continuous flow of data. An application programming interface, API, is developed for periodic or live platform updates. Just like digital monitoring systems installed in beehives, an API is developed to automatically transfer data from the data provider to the EU Pollinator Hub. Finally, one of the main goals is to visualise the integrated data. This means that new data is aggregated and made available to the public in an easily accessible visual way. Through an interactive map, users will be able to navigate a never-before-seen collection of data relevant to pollinators. Not only can the users find never-published data, but they can also make use of this tool to assess and to strategically create solutions to minimise risks for pollinators. The work done so far shows that in Europe, a lot of research exists about bees and pollinators, but in many cases, it is difficult both for practitioners and decision makers to make use out of this data. The EU Pollinator Hub works online, designed to integrate data and present it in an easy visual way, where everyone can access ready-to-use information through interactive graphs and maps. This new platform is a solution-oriented tool for pressing issues that relate to the environmental, socio-economic, and technological challenges surrounding pollinators. If you have data on pollinators and wish to take part in this new platform, you can become a data provider. Any new provider is welcome to contribute to the EU Pollinator Hub and help build the future of data for the well-being of pollinators. With comprehensive data sharing agreements, your ownership of data and your privacy are highly valued and protected. The EU Pollinator Hub could transform our ability to understand and manage the risks affecting pollinators. A new community is growing, with people coming together to combine their data in pursuit of a common objective: a better future for pollinators and biodiversity.